Hello, and welcome to this tutorial for Schoolhouse Test 4. In this video, I will be demonstrating how to work with fill-in-the-blank questions. So the first thing I need to do is have a test document open. So in this case, I've just opened a new blank test by clicking on the new button. But I've already got that open. So it can be a new blank test, or it can be a test that you're already working on. It doesn't matter. And in order to get started, I'm going to click on Fill in the Blanks under Question Items in the Item Selection pane. Now, as with all of the questions, there are a variety of things that you can fill in: status, level, category, group, tag, marks, notes. I can even add a picture. But just to get started, I'm going to put my first sentence in here. The cow jumped over the moon. Okay. Now for this particular sentence, I want to remove the word jumped. I can either highlight it and click select, or in the case of just removing a single word, you can double click and it removes the word. If I wanted to take out moon, I could double click and it would be removed. But in this case, I'm just going to take jumped out. And if I go into document view, I can see my sentence and I can see the answer. Alright. Now, I'm going to add my second fill in the blanks question. So I go back over to the item selection pane, click on fill in the blanks, and I can add my second fill in the blanks question. Oops. The dish ran away with a spoon. Great. Now, with this particular fill in the blanks question, I want to remove a phrase. I want to remove ran away with. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to highlight this phrase and then click select. So now I've removed the entire phrase, and when I look in document view, there it is. Alright, and I'm going to add one more fill in the blanks question. Let's see. Jack and Jill ran up the hill. Great. Now, generally, you probably will want the line length for the word that you removed to be of a standard size. But occasionally, you may want to make the line longer. So, if I select long, I get even a longer space. Or I can select longer and get even a bigger space. So if I go into document view, I've got a huge space then for the answer. But for my purposes, I'm going to set it back to standard. The one thing to keep in mind is if you want to use one of these other line lengths, set the line length before you type the word before you make your removal. But if you forget to do that, you can always just reset. So if I selected ran and I thought, oh darn gosh, I wanted to use a longer one, I could reset and set this to longer and then select ran again. Alright. So that's just a quick review of how to enter your sentences in the program and how to remove words and phrases. Answer sheet view will just show you the answers, and there aren't any other settings that are particular for fill in the blanks. But in document view, there are a couple of settings that you can adjust. And the thing with document options is it applies to all questions of that type. So when I make my settings here, all fill in the blanks questions will have these adjustments made. So you'll see in design view that we've added numbers in here where we have removed the words. And that's just so that the program can keep track of the removed words. We'll get rid of spoon in there as well so you can see a couple of them. So yeah, so there's just some numbering here to keep track of the words that are removed. And in document view, by default, you'll see that we've put in uppercase lettering for the words. But you can also switch that out for lowercase numbering or numeric numbering if you like, or you can remove it altogether if you don't want any numbering at all. So they'll just be blanks and a place for the students to write the answers. The other option that you might want to work with is extra line spacing, and you just click here, and what that does is it just puts more space between the lines so that when the students write, they have a little more writing space with the blank lines. So there we go. That's just a quick review of working with fill-in-the-blanks questions. Thank you for watching this Schoolhouse Test 4 tutorial. For more details, check the help documentation included with the program or contact us by email or through the support section of our website.